the BPO. So I think our point was that you increasing the market share and moving up the value chain, that is actually a target of the association and of the government. So given the decline in the innovation performance, we wonder how these targets could be achieved. So that is, it's not the other way around, that, you know. And I also want to just echo his comment about the foreign Filipinos. If you recall in one of the slides, he emphasized removing the weeds. And I think that's really the most important, or one of the most important aspects of attracting our best and the brightest to come back. I think at that stage, they're not really that keen on the money or on the financial aspects, but more about, you know, just having an environment where they can actually contribute. If you're going to make it difficult for them, that's really going to discourage the return of these professionals. And in fact, in PIDS, we have this regulatory audit in services. So we're trying to identify all the restrictions, all the measures that inhibit the flow of goods, services, talent, capital, and all that. So you know, we're very keen on really trying to focus on removing the weeds. Finally, on the question of Celia, I think it's really important to look at the affiliation, which we, I think in the model or in the data set, you cannot really investigate that further, but maybe through case studies, because I agree that if, especially now we talk about global value chains, and your role in the global value chain really determines to what extent you can innovate. So if you're just second tier or whatever, you cannot really introduce product innovation because this is determined in headquarters, right? So I totally agree. We need to do a further investigation on the affiliations and how we fit in global value chains, and this might be different from one industry to the next, to further understand what forms of innovation we can.